Welcome, calculator fanciers, to NumberFile's series of unboxing videos. My name's Matt Parker, and I will be looking at these three fantastic specimens for you today. Okay, so we'll start with the Morrisons desktop calculator. Those of you not from the UK, Morrisons is a particularly classy shop over here. Think kind of Harrods. £2 is not a bad amount of money. Now, what I like about this is before you're committing to that kind of investment, because it's in a transparent blister pack and because it's reasonably flexible, you can actually turn it on while it's in there and you can test it in the shop. 7 times 7, make sure we get 49. And you kind of know what you're getting in for before you buy it. We, however, have shelled out both of those pounds, so we will open it up and see what we're actually dealing with. The blister pack is surprisingly easy to cut through. Here we go. As you can see, I am very safely cutting towards my body at all times so I can keep a closer eye on the blade. We now pop this open. There we are. Oh, okay. So first thing out is an instruction booklet, which is in case you're unfamiliar with the concept of numbers being represented by digits. We'll leave that for later reference should we get confused. And there is no other real information on the packet. Again, it tells you to not put it in the bin because it is a calculator and it's very difficult to use in a bin. In fact, that is repeated on the leaflet over there. And Morrisons do claim that they are here to help. I'm sure if we do ring their helpline, which they give you here, if we have any calculation or mathematical inquiries about the calculator, they should be able to help us out. Okay, so we'll get it out of its packet. There we are. And yes, as you can see, it looks alarmingly similar to what it did inside the packet. There's two tiny screws on the back, but it is solar powered, so that should be fine. The display is pretty good. We can get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 8. We can get 8 digits. It can do all the 4 major functions. It can add, subtract, multiply, and divide. It's also got a square root, which is very interesting. In fact, we'll take the square root for a spin. We'll put in 2 square root, and that looks pretty accurate to me. And then just as a test, we'll multiply that by the square root of 2, and the answer is 1.9999998. Okay, that's a little bit out. In fact, we can try a classic one. Okay, 1 divided by 0 equals error again. Okay, no problem. Okay, so accuracy is not brilliant. Functions are perfectly passable. If we cover up the screen there, it's got a decent battery life. So should it become temporarily overcast, you can continue calculating. And in terms of holding in the hand, it's not great. It's a bit awkward to hold, to be honest. But then again, as you can see, they very explicitly say put it on top of a desk. So we can't take too many points off for that. And on a desk, I think that works quite nicely. The scores for the Morrisons desktop calculator. For display, I've given it 5. Big but not enough digits. Functionality, 5. Accuracy, 3. Can't do root 2. In terms of ergonomics, I've given it a 4. Its overall cred, a 2. You wouldn't want to be seen on the street using this one. And for durability, survived the fall quite well, I give it a 6. That's a total of 25, which is an average score of 4.16 reoccurring. Okay, so up next we have the WH Smith scientific calculator for using while doing science. They make a few hidden claims on the side here, that there is a 10-digit display, which we will be the judges of, that it's battery powered, and that it's got 136 functions. It's quite impressive. And on the back here, they just basically list not all 136 functions, but a decent number of them, and a life-size 1-to-1 scale of the screen showing everything at once. So I guess if you actually see that, your calculator has crashed. Oh, and again, this one is not for doing calculations in a bin. Should you accidentally overcut, the problem is you will no longer be able to keep your calculator in its original packet. So please be very careful when you open this to get a kind of hinging effect so you can return the calculator here for display purposes afterwards. Oh, as always, an instruction booklet, and this is substantially more than the Morrisons. Look at this. Before starting calculations, so we have important warnings to use before you even start. You know what, let's be mavericks and just dive straight in without reading any of that. So, oh, it's got a case. Should your calculator be at risk of splashes, you can slide this from only one of the two directions, and that is not indicated anywhere on the packet, so a little bit confusing. And it does click into place, very nice. And should you need to eject it, there is a thumb bit at the bottom there. Very, very useful. Accuracy-wise, we can check the square root test. So 2 square root multiplied by 2 square root equals 2, much better. So square root's perfectly accurate. We have trigonometric functions. So let's have some fun with those. So a very interesting test for trigonometric functions is to see how small an angle you can still calculate the sine of. And so we will switch this into radians. Now we're in radians, we will take the sine of a very small angle. And if we do a sine of, let's say 0.1, the answer, this is the small angle approximation, should be about the same number. So it gives me about 0.1, but slightly different. If I do a smaller angle, so clear that, 0.01 sine, I get, again, closer to what I started with, and the point where it can no longer tell the difference between an angle and the sine of the angle gives you a test of how accurate its trigonometric function is. So it can do 0.01, 0.001. Okay, that's still slightly different. And then 0.0001, slightly different, 0.00001, that's 4 zeros and a 1, and it's exactly the same. Okay, so at this point, it can't tell the difference between the angle and the sine of the angle. So as far as calculators are concerned, getting to 10^-4 and still being able to tell the difference and not being able to at 10^-5 is average to good. I mean, it's all right, but I wouldn't write a song about it. Okay, so I mean, there are loads of other functions here, but I think we'll just now, instead of testing how accurate they are, because I think the trigonometric test is pretty good, we will see how it handles errors. So we'll put in a negative number, we'll put in -5. Where is my negative? Take the square root of that, error. Error and 0, cool. And we'll try 1/0, and that's, again, error and 0. And we'll see if it does the correct order of operation. So I'm gonna do 5 plus 2 times 5. And if it does it correctly, we should get 15. If it does it wrong, we'll get 35. And it does it correctly, we got 15. So it is doing correct orders of operation. That's very impressive. This is not a bad all-round calculator. I'm very impressed with it. And it's got a tiny screw there. Should you do so many calculations, you need to put in a new battery. Scores for the WH Smith Scientific Calculator. For the display, I've given it a 7 out of 10. In terms of functionality, 8. Accuracy, 8. Ergonomics, a 7. It does fit very snugly in the hand. In terms of cred, I'd give it a 7. It hasn't got branding, but it looks pretty slick. And now in terms of durability, survived the fall pretty poorly. That's a 4 for a grand total of 41, an average score of 6.83 reoccurring. Okay, and finally we have the Canon with the arc design. And you may think I'm showing you the back of the box here, but in fact I'm not, because the front of the box is near the back of the box. It does have a lot more information. In fact, even a picture, because I guess you can't see through the packet. This is entirely opaque. Oh, and you see, unlike the other ones, they have packaged it in a kind of cuboid of cardboard, which is quite nice. It's, topologically equivalent to the 2-sphere, and it is able to contain something quite nicely in R3. So I'm very impressed with the packaging there. Okay, so there we are. So that's opened that up nicely. And then in here, it appears to, okay, that's not a smooth slide out. That it's sticking quite a bit. That's not very good, I guess, for protection and safety. And should you get any spills or splashes, maybe you can keep this. So should you be calculating in a wet environment, or maybe you're using it in the shower or a swimming pool, you can put the protective splash layer back over it. I suspect it wouldn't be good if it's actually submerged, though. However, I will remove that for now. As you can see, it's in no way sealed to allow easy reinsertion of the calculator into its protective cover. And we are also given, here we go, instruction booklet. Wow, this is possibly, by surface area, even bigger than the instructions we had for the WH Smith one. Again, if you're unfamiliar with what buttons do and what digits are, they're all over here. And then should you wish to learn a foreign language, they have lessons in foreign languages on this side. Again, we have an on and off button, but suspiciously no off button. In this case, I think once you start calculating, they correctly assume you're simply not going to stop. Function-wise, we have the 4 standard guys hanging out in the corner here, and then we have M's with different numbers of lines and crosses next to them, and some level of memory. And then this is the Greek letter mu, So should you be calculating any densities, you can use mu, and should you be using this to do calculations in an RV, let's say you're making math, you can use the RV mode. Maybe this makes it more shock resistant if you switch into RV or off-road mode, or GT is if you're racing with the calculator. It is a bit big, to be honest. I'm struggling to hold that entirely in one hand, whereas if you remember the WH Smith job, look at that. That's a nice little tiny package that fits very snugly in the hand. It's got good reach. I can go all the way across. I mean, it's ambidextrous, whereas this one, I mean, if I was suddenly, you know, needed GT mode at short notice, I can't reach that with the one-handed mode. It would have to be put down and then used from here. But it does have a slightly raised 5. Which is very good. So if you're calculating in the dark, you know, after hours calculations, you can still find your way to the 5, and then you can extrapolate where all the other buttons are from there. Oh, and you can see in addition to the normal 0, it's got the double 0. That's for when things are really 0. I mean, this one's pretty 0, and this one's absolute 0. So we'll do the square root of 2, and load, I mean, wow, how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 9, 10, 11, 12! 12 digits! That's amazing! I'm surprised they don't write that right across the top. Oh, they do. There it is. 12 digits. That is an impressive display. But let's see how the accuracy goes. Multiply that by the square root of 2 and we get... It has put it into racing mode, which is good to see. But it has just got lots of 9s, which is a real shame there. So, alarmingly close. Another test we can do to see if it can redeem its accuracy is if we do 1 divided by 9, so we get a 9th. If we now multiply that by 9, if it's really accurate, we'll get 1 back. If it's not accurate, we'll get 0.9 reoccurring. And we get 0.9 reoccurring. So this is not good for the accuracy. I mean, it's got a lot of digits it can show you. Unfortunately, it doesn't need to use all of them. In fact, it just shows you lots and lots of inaccurate digits. I mean, on the whole, I think it's quite a nice calculator. And again, it's got screws on the back should you wish to update the battery. It's battery and solar powered, as indicated on here. Solar and battery. That's so during normal use, it can be powered by free photons. But should this be a post-nuclear winter, you can continue calculating solely on the battery. So there you are. That, ladies and gentlemen, is the Canon. Scores for the Canon AS120 with the Arc design. Display, 9. Lots of digits, nice and big. Functionality, only a 6. Accuracy, I've given it a 6.9999999. Ergonomics, a 5. It may be arced, but it's still hard to hold. In terms of cred, a 6. You could get away with using this in a maths department. And for durability, with the protective cover, it handles water very well. I'm giving it a 7 for a total score of 39.99999, which is an average of 6.6666542, possibly a 7.
What did the number 0 say to the number 8? Nice belt. Why do mathematicians confuse Halloween and Christmas? Because Oct 31 equals Dec 25. There are 10 types of people in the world. Those who understand binary, those who don't, and those who didn't expect this joke to be in base 3.